Hello. Hi, I'm Patricia McNeely. I'm an illumined Blu-ray twin flame from Chicago, Illinois. Happy Valentine's Day to you. Thank you for watching. And that's what this video is. It's just a happy Valentine's Day wish. Now, I've found out through a lot of my readings from people in different parts of the world that Valentine's Day is not celebrated everywhere. And a lot of people have different perceptions of what is Valentine's Day. Also, a lot of people have become a little bit discouraged with how commercialized some of it's gotten. And if you look at the original story, it's actually an improvement over how it originally started. Yet, the spirit of Valentine's Day is love and romance. And for a lot of people who are twin flames, you embody that. It's who you are. You can't help but express love, feel love, be the love, and the romance. Not too many people are lacking in the romance department in terms of how you express it. Now, there's something significant about this Valentine's Day. This is truly the one for the true lovers, because the red ray of passion is actually returning. And even those twin flames who have felt like they're just friends, or you're meeting each other, has been in the context of work, school, professional capacity, or even that you met as friends and you feel like you're friends and you feel like you're just friends. It's going to get deeper. It's going to get better, deeper, deeply intimate. And yes, there's going to be even more that happens for people. I know that there's a lot of people around this time of year that get really upset with where their love life is. And I want to say a couple things about that. You're not part of the Lonely Hearts Club here on Earth. You're actually the cosmic heart of love who is here on Earth. So, should we call it the Cosmic Hearts Club? Maybe. But for your individual unions, you want to throw out some words to you. Kindness, gentleness, devotion, persistence, reliance, loyalty, trust, honor. This is everything that you embody. These are descriptions of what your makeup is. It's also your twin. And some of my turning points, and I've been one of those people who's gone all out for a soulmate, you know, gotten the cards, the flowers, the chocolates, the special dinners, etc., etc., only to find that things went flat. And I would always long for the love that never leaves, only to find that meant twin flame. That meant the person who is embodying my other half. That is what many of us are seeking, whether we call it, it is sometimes called soulmate, but what people mean with that is usually their other half, their literal other half, not someone from a group. And this is where you're going to see things radically start to change in groups, mini groups, amongst people, because you're all going at a different speed. And there's no right or wrong with that. Some people are only at a certain speed. So a couple of things just to talk about for Happy Valentine's Day are some of the things that you may or may not have learned over the journey. So for me, some of it's summed up in some of these cards that I've kept. And this one says, on every flower, a little rain must fall. And we've all felt the storminess of unions or things with other people, the drama, the up and down, feeling like we're in a deluge. And inside it says, not to mention a whole bunch of fertilizer. And what's the fertilizer? It's usually manure, or essentially it's crap. But out of the crap, beautiful things grow. And when you start getting rid of the crap, things continue blossoming. So I want to encourage you, continue moving through your stuff. Continue getting the crud out. And this card sort of is a good reminder. The other one that I have, now this really sort of struck me. Can you see that? Love is in the air. And on the inside, and I'm sure a lot of people have said that seen this one, along with toxins and carcinogens and flakes of dead skin and dust particles and flying insects and mold spores and killer viruses. Ooh, love you. This was a funny card that he picked up at a card place. They have all kinds of cards. But this one, when I got it, my guidance actually said to me, because this was indicative of the things that people see in the air, the things that people have been afraid of, and the things that are still making people afraid. It's stuff collected to the mental and emotional. It is stuff that has actually happened to people. It's true that people have breathed things and have gotten cancers. It's true that people have been in toxic environments. It is true that people have been exposed to viruses or molds, many times unwittingly, and sometimes without intention. But those hidden things are coming out. So in the broader picture, they're coming out. And even things, I'm going to say it right here, you know, some of the things that people believe are affecting them. What my message was, what are you going to give your belief to? Are you believing that there's something more powerful that's not pure, that is affecting you, and you will never be able to heal it or overcome it? Or are you believing that the love will purify, transmute, transform, and bring you out of that? What are you going to believe? And today I want to encourage you, believe in love. Believe in a love, that twin flame love is more powerful and supersedes everything. Everything here. That love is what moves mountains. That love is what moves the earth. That love is what changes the elemental particles inside you. And even if people are going to cry, what is the alchemical process that happens inside you? It's not like you say, oh, hey, I'm going to have a good cry. Wait, I need to get some salt and some protein in a bowl, and I'm going to mix it all together and make some tears. Your body is already doing that. The magic exists within you. It's fueled by the heart. It's fueled by the desire of your heart. So that in a really much more profound way, a deep way, that you're affecting these changes. The other message I have for you, there's a couple of them today. Today is an Eight of Cups, okay? Eight of Hearts, Eight of Cups. And what is this card? What does this signify? I didn't find this on the ground like I usually find things. I actually was prompted, today's an Eight of Cups. What this means is, it means changes. It still means changes, but in a balanced way. The eights are balanced. Eight is a twin flame number. It's also an even number. It's a number of balance. And the cups is the heart, as it, you know, depicted here, it's hearts. But this is also leaving situations by changing things by actually leaving. It is abandoning things that don't work without a crisis, without a knockdown, drag out fight. with a simple inner acknowledgement that when you've gone through some of this darkness of, you know, the mold spores and the toxins from other people, and some of you might have it, you might say, I am like up to here with these people breathing my air, my goodness. And yet, what is the crisis? What are the things that affect the heart and stress you? You've been being shown what those are. And you can exit gracefully now. That's what this card is. It's the spiritual maturity that you're using from the inside and from a higher level, along with the trust, the devotion, the honor, the integrity to make things right, to put things in their proper place in relation to your union. What are some of the small things? If you're devoted to your twin and you say, well, how could I help their heart? And this has been something that irks me out there, where I see people who pretend to know what a twin flame is, and I'm sorry, but some people just don't because they haven't had the direct experience of it. They think they do. They think they do because they're having a higher expression of love, or sometimes it's just sex, but it's better sex than they ever had. What I will say to you is that some of those people are saying the biggest sex organ is the brain. The biggest sex organ is the biggest sex organs. But the biggest thing is the love organ. It's the heart. What are the things that affect your true love's heart if you were devoted? What are some of the things that you might give that person a break with? Is it stressing? Is it not catching your balance? Is it not finding that place within you? Let's take something really simple. Okay? Coffee. Coffee or tea. Some caffeine. Is too much caffeine affecting you or your twin, or could it? A lot of people, while you're coming together close on this journey, you're being affected in your heart. That's pretty big heart. And what I want to let you know is that I wrote it here. Love will find perfection even in imperfection. To keep gazing upon your twin and to see them as beautiful as when you first saw them, or when you first became aware of them in your dreams. You don't focus on their imperfections. You focus instead on what you know inside is perfect. The perfection is on the inside. That's your light body. And they're in there. They're in there. They're connected inside you. You're connected inside them. If you're giving your twin a hard time, you're literally putting your hand out to the other part of you that's in them. Don't do that anymore. It's that simple. If you know something's not healthy for you, if you know a situation isn't, exit gracefully and graciously. The way to do that is to say a proper thank you. Not to the person, the roommate, the spouse, the job, the boss, the house, whatever it is. You do it in the heart, and you are enabled to very gracefully, as only the heart does, in an honorable and highly integrated and loving way to move on. Because you're properly concluding things. There's a way of being proper, and there's a way of being improper. And the improper way will lead to things like restraining orders, judges, police, all the kind of things that really don't belong in your union. All of the other toxic things that don't belong there. What is your twin believing that's showing up in your dreams at night? Are you seeing apocalyptic things? Are they focusing on that? Where is their focus and how do you pull them back? That's what you want to do. You want to pull your love into the safety. The red passion is going to come. trust me. This eight is abandoning old things. It is the emotional changes. And it is also the emotional and spiritual maturity to do so, the acknowledgments, the doing things properly. And if you're getting nowhere, I encourage you, go back to the drawing board. The drawing board's inside you. It's not going to be out there in a forum. It's not going to be the Cosmic Heart Club is something you're a part of. If you rely on other people's heads, that's what you're going to get. You're going to get a whole bunch of heads. And I'm reminded of a little joke I saw earlier this week. And the joke was a 95-year-old woman. So she was, it showed on her face. But she said, I have one wrinkle and I'm sitting on it. Everyone has that wrinkle and we're all sitting on it. But don't let that wrinkle run your head. Don't be that wrinkle. Don't be the butt crack. Keep going here. Focus on love. It is love that purifies these things. You want it to the point where your love finds all of the perfections that you are. And it doesn't matter. You could look at your twin and say, gosh, even your tooth fillings are so cute. I just love it that your parents loved you and took you to the dentist. Or, you know, that little freckle, that scar. And I must say, I've always found scars on people interesting because scars always have a story. We all have battle scars. All of us. I don't care who your twin is. If they're in the limelight, if they're on a show, if they are somehow in the public eye, or if they're a recluse suffering from agoraphobia or something, you're going to know them from the inside. You're not here to know their fears. You're here to help alleviate their fears so you continue coming together. Everything about them should be beautiful and that you love it. It's up to you to be devoted. It's your plan. You are part of the divine plan. And you are here by invitation. People don't just incarnate into this density. You're pretty well equipped to be here. But a lot of people have forgotten. Not everyone's awake. Not every twin is awake, even though the other twin might be. And yeah, some people are bumping up against what they think they know, and it's going to get better. So the last thing I'll leave you with is keep clearing things. If you don't know how, check out my website. That's all I'll say. You want it to this point, love and romance. When I saw you, I fell in love, and you smiled because you knew. You want them to just know. Whether you've already met each other, whether you live together, whether you're yet to meet, whether you're waiting and expectant, be expectant, because when you see, you'll know and they know. Don't give up. Happy Valentine's Day. Take good care of yourself. That's always a given. You should always be vigilant about your own body, your own safety, and your own environment to the best of your ability. Keep yourself lighthearted. Have some fun today. I know not everyone celebrates it. I mean, that was sort of a surprise to me, but I'm, you know, not unaware that in different places in the world, people celebrate different things. People celebrate love, though, in different ways, and that's what the spirit of today is. Here, especially for people in Europe, North America, some places in South America, some other parts of the world like Asia, Russia. Some people have heard about it from relatives who've come here to the United States, and I'm finding a lot of traditions or things that we've started up go back and forth. But please be in love. When I saw you, I fell in love, and you're going to fall in love over and over and over. The love is what removes things. It's always been that way, and it will always be that way. What won't always be is the necessity to continue removing things. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful weekend. Take care, and we'll talk soon. Bye now.